Okay, so I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the Oxy Ridge aid station. This aid station is. Okay, so I want to talk to you a little bit about the Oxy Ridge aid station. This aid station is a 50K only aid station. It is mile 8.5 and 13.5 approximately of the 50K. The 22K does not come all the way out to Oxy Ridge. I've done my best to kind of illustrate it here on the screen for you, even though it's very primitive and I'm a shitty drawer. Anyway, so what you're looking at here is this is Tunnel Ridge Road right here, and then the parking lot up in this region up here. So what the runners are going to be doing, if you're familiar with the area, you've kind of got some parking spaces in this region right here, and then you've got some outhouses up here at the end of the ridge, and then the trailhead is right here, and then Tunnel Ridge Road continues on up here. And up that direction. So what the runners are going to be doing is they're going to hit Gray's Arch, which is further down that way, and they're going to be running up Tunnel Ridge Road this way. They're going to come on up through the parking lot, and they're going to whip on up the trailhead that direction, and they're going to make the loop counterclockwise like that. Okay, so they're going to be running up and up into the trailhead like that. And then later, they're going to be coming out that Forest Service Road this way, and then they'll proceed on back down Tunnel Ridge Road. So they'll basically be coming out here and doing this big kind of loop like that. So what I think is best and what I'm going to recommend is putting the aid station right here. We want to stay out of the way of cars and everything, so we want to make sure that we leave enough room for vehicles to get back and forth that direction. But I think that's a good spot. You might also look at putting it over here, closer to those areas. But either way, somewhere in this area right here, I'm going to recommend putting it right here or right here, just off into the grass a little bit. So that way, as runners come up, let's say we put it right here. So this is the aid station here. So runners are going to come up. They'll be able to hit your aid station here at mile 8.5. And then you can just direct them up this way. So you might want to have somebody there just telling them, hey, keep running up the parking lot and then take a left. We're going to have ribbons and things, and we might even have a sign right there that tells them which way to go. So they will know which way to go. So essentially, again, they'll come up the road, hit your aid station, go up the trail that direction. And then when they come, they will just come back down this way, on around a little turnabout, and they can hit your aid station again here. And that will be mile 13.5 approximately. So they can hit your aid station there. We'll probably put a sign here that points them to go that direction as opposed to running around here. So we'll take care of that. So we'll put a sign here that points that direction, and then we'll have ribbons all around there showing them which way to go. We'll also have ribbons all around here, just so they know which way to go. So let me clear all that out. So again, let's run through one more time. They're going to come up here 8.5 miles. Then they're going to run on up the trail. They're going to do their loop. They're going to come down the road, turn this direction. They can hit your aid station again, and then they'll go out. When they get to your aid station, you are going to have to check them in and check them out each time they come out. So when they come out here and they hit you at 8.5 miles, well, they're not going to hit you, but when they get to the aid station at 8.5 miles, you're going to check them in, check them out. The runners know to shout their bib number to the volunteers, so they're going to do that. You just need to record their bib number, and it's going to what you're going to have is you're going to have a check-in, check-out sheet. It's going to look something like this. It'll have bib numbers populated here. It'll have the distance for them. In your case, for Oxy Ridge, it's all going to be 50K. And then I'll have their name over here. So what you'll do is when they show up and whatever time it is. If it's 3 hours into the race, so you just you write in 3 hours or whatever it is, or you can write the time of day, whatever it might be. So you're gonna need to have one volunteer dedicated solely to filling this thing out, and that's for safety reasons and for integrity reasons. Integrity meaning that, so we know that everybody went the entire course, nobody took any shortcuts, everybody went where they were supposed to be, and also for safety, so we can easily look through here and see who came to the aid station and who we might still be missing. So what you'll want to do is you'll want to have one person here dedicated to doing the check-in, check-out. One person maybe directing the runners, telling them which way to go, telling them, hey, make sure you go up this way. And then when they come back, telling them, hey, make sure you keep going out the road. So one person doing the check-in, check-out sheet, one person directing runners, and then one person just kind of helping out, helping the runners get their water and everything else. So that is Oxy Ridge Aid Station. If you want to hear about any of the other aid stations, check out our website, go to the volunteer tab, and click on the videos link.